our friend Luis Valdes, who is the Florida State Director for Gun Owners of America, firearms collector. He says he's a commie hater too, so we just immediately became best friends. Luis, it's so good to see you. Thank you for joining me. So I'm just going to, what is the thing with open carry? Why can't you open carry in Florida? How in the world did we beat you with this?
Well, it's real simple. There's one person to thank for this. Janet Reno is the reason why we don't have open carry in Florida. And it goes back to 1987 when Florida became shall issue with concealed carry permits. During a special legislative session for tax policy, of all things, Janet Reno, then as the Dade County State Attorney, lobbied the lawmakers to ban open carry. And we've had a ban on open carry since then.
She follows some of the worst things ever as it relates to 2A issues. Just going to say, she follows some really bad things. So that it's been that long. So constitutional carry, because I can't believe that you can't open carry there. I started hearing some criticisms of the constitutional carry bill that's going forward in Florida. And I thought that maybe y'all were dealing with something like with what we had to do up until it was like September 21, where we could open carry if we had our concealed carry permit, which, you know, makes all the sense in the world, I guess, to a bureaucrat. But in Florida, you will be able to concealed carry without a permit, but you still can't open carry. So my question to you, Luis, is why does it matter if it's covered by a piece of cloth or not?
Well, that's the biggest issue with this piece of legislation. Republicans are advertising it as being constitutional carry when it's not, because every state that has passed constitutional carry has had two critical pieces in it. The ability to carry openly or concealed without a permit. And Florida is still banning open carry. Florida is the only Republican state that bans open carry. And out of the entire country, 47 states and 2 U.S. territories have open carry on the books in one form or another. Only Florida, Illinois, and New York outright ban it, except if you're hunting or fishing.
That is insane. We're talking with Luis Valdes, who is the Florida State Director for Gun Owners of America. One of the things that I come across, and I'm sure you hear this too, Luis, is that people will say, and you know, they're like-minded for the most part, but they say things like, well, you know, it's, and I understand their arguments. They're saying it's a tactical advantage to be concealed, you know, and you should want to be able to carry concealed. And I agree with that, but why do I, you're eliminating choice. And that's where the freedom lies, is within the choice to be able to choose between one or the other. And sometimes, you know, I have talked about this on air before, sometimes, especially for women, you know, if you're leaving the grocery store late at night, as I used to have to do when I worked in downtown St. Louis and I had a radio show that was on in the evenings and I didn't get home until 11 o'clock. And if I had to stop or if I had an emergency, sometimes it is a little deterrence if everyone sees your heads on a swivel and that you're looking around and you've got, you know, in some instances, especially for women, I do think that it is advantageous. But, you know, again, special circumstances. But Luis, it comes down to the choice. So what do you tell people when they say things? What is your response when they say things like that to you?
My response to them is very simple. In 2011, we had an open carry bill go through the Republican-controlled legislature, and it was gutted by Republicans to be an accidental exposure-only law. So it's 790.053 is the state statute, and it says that if there's a brief or accidental exposure of your firearm, it's not an arrestable offense. Well, the problem is, since that law was passed in 2011, you've had people specifically arrested for having brief and accidental exposures of their concealed firearms, and they've been charged with open carrying a firearm. So the entire push for why we need to have open carry is it removes any and all doubt of law enforcement to harass law-abiding, concealed carry gun owners, because the biggest issue in Florida is our own Florida Sheriff's Association is vehemently anti-gun. The current chairman of the FSA has said that he's against open carry. The previous chairman, who is now their legislative lobbyist, has said he's against open carry. And, you know, these are Republican sheriffs that run on being pro-gun, yet they back gun control. We have Republican lawmakers that campaign on being pro-gun, yet they are upholding Janet Reno, one of the worst Democrat gun control advocates in this nation's history. They're upholding her gun control policies. And remember, Yesterday was the anniversary, the 30th anniversary of the Waco siege when it started. And that was started by Janet Reno, of all people. Why are Republicans upholding Democrat gun control policies?
That's the question. $1 million question. That's a great question. Why are they? So that brings me. So explain this, that, because I know every state has different procedures. They have a different process, different protocol. I understand this. I'm very respectful of that. However, I also realize that, you know, this bill is still in its infancy. It came out of committee. So there's still time to make some changes, correct?
There's still times to make changes. Traditionally in Florida, a bill has to go through three committees before it goes to the floor. But that's actually up to the legislative leadership. They could change the rules on a whim, and they did for these two bills. It's only going through two committees before it goes to the floor. So the House version already went through both of its committees. The Senate version went through its first committee. It has one more to go. And at every committee, gun owners have asked the same question, and they've stated the same. They've made the same statement. We support the bill. We want open carry added to it. And not a single Republican has added an amendment to do this.
Why? What are they afraid of?
It comes down to legislative leadership. We spoke with some key Republican lawmakers in some of the committees, and literally they told us that the Republican legislative leadership, the House Speaker and the Senate President, are against adding open carry. And that if they support any amendment to add open carry to it by any means, they will literally be exiled, banished to the basement, stripped of their committee seats, and any other bill that they're pushing will be blocked. And this happened previously with a former state representative by the name of Anthony Sabatini, who introduced constitutional carry 3 years in a row, and it was blocked. And this is the worst thing. The committee chair last year that blocked the bill, who threw away gun owners' petitions asking him to bring the bill up for a vote in committee, he is the House bill sponsor this year for the permitless concealed carry only bill. And when asked by the media if open carry will be added, he said the bill is as it is and it is not being changed.
That's wow. That just goes to show you, we're talking with Loesch Valdes, who's the Florida State Director for Gun Owners of America, that you could have a majority in the legislature, Republican, like in Texas. That doesn't necessarily mean that, you know, these are gun owners or that these are people who even understand what that is or, you know, what any of this or even support any of it. So if they're blocking it, my next question to you is, I like to go above people's heads. Is that possible? Can you go above somebody's head? Can you go all the way to the top and say, hey, can we make this demand? Can we put some pressure on these people? Is that something the governor's office can do? Is that possible? I don't know the process for how that would happen, but I just like to go above people's heads and be like, can we do this? Is this something that we can put in here?
In Florida, we can do that. The governor, he can't directly tell the legislature what to do, but he could crack the political whip and use his office as a bully pulpit. And he's done that in the past. Previously, when it came to congressional redistricting, the Republican legislature sent him a map that he didn't agree with. He vetoed it, basically wrote his own, found someone in the legislature willing to submit it and said, pass this version. And that's exactly what happened. So DeSantis can crack the whip and say, I want a real constitutional carry bill with open carry added to it. And we've been pressuring him to do that. The question is, but this is not the question. The issue is, he hasn't done that thus far. He hasn't cracked the political whip. He hasn't told the legislature, this is what I want on my desk. He's basically been playing it very safe with the legislature right now. And personally, I think the governor's pro-gun. But politically, it appears that gun rights isn't a top issue for him, and he's fine with whatever they send him.
Do you think that they're worried, talking with Loesch Valdes, Florida State Director of Gun Owners of America, are they worried that, because I know everyone's been celebrating that two-thirds supermajority and that the legislature, it's very, because I wonder whether or not, you know, this would have even been an issue. Well, I think this would have been a huge issue back in maybe 2018 and even maybe before then. But now it seems like it's a little bit easier. You were saying that, you know, they were vetoing this, or not vetoing it, but putting it back, the previous proposal like 3 years ago. Is there a worry that like they may lose some of that power in the state legislature? Because to think that, you know, you could take out like the House Speaker and, you know, strip them of committees, that's like some pretty serious political warfare. Is that the hesitancy?
That is very much the hesitancy from the rank and file lawmaker. They are truly afraid of legislative leadership being legislative dictators and literally squashing everything that they do. And we've heard this from multiple lawmakers. You even had last year, Representative Michelle Salzman up from the Panhandle. She was caught on video telling the Republican National Hispanic Assembly that she supports constitutional carry. She supports open carry. But the problem is that the legislative leadership would literally kill everything she does if she backs it. And just to give you a really bad taste in your mouth, the House Speaker and the Senate President, Paul Renner and Kathleen Passidemo, they unanimously supported the Parkland gun control bill, which stripped everyone under the age of 21 from legally purchasing a firearm, instituting mandatory waiting periods across the state of Florida, instituting red flag laws across the state of Florida, and instituting a bump stock ban that is so vague and poorly written that literally if I took my pistol to a gunsmith to have him install a lightened trigger in it, to make it a competition grade pistol, it could possibly be in violation of the law and charge me with a felony. And this was Republicans that did this.
This is infuriating. Luis Valdes, and you can find him at Real FL Gun Lobby as well, Florida State Director for Gun Owners of America. I'm sure that you all, because I would love to share it, I'm sure you all have a list of these lawmakers in Florida that, you know, we can just send out to people. That'd be, you know, just so people can very politely and civilly make some suggestions about what needs to be added to this constitutional carry bill. Because Floridians, you guys cannot, we have a lot of affiliates in Florida, they cannot be happy with Texas beating them in this, surely.
Look, here's the honest truth about Florida versus Texas. You guys have open carry, you guys have campus carry, you guys have constitutional carry.
That's a little bit campus carry, not on the private institutions, but.
But you guys have all that. We have none of that.
Well, you guys have been making a lot of ground because I remember in 2012, y'all were blue. I watched those votes come in and I was like, oh my gosh. So you guys have actually done more than I think any other state. And also I think with 2A advocacy, you guys have been doing some real great work there because you've made gained a lot of ground in 10 years time. So I think that's to be commended. But yeah, we still are beating you on that. We're still beating you on that. I'll take that. That's. But you have something that I'm going to make sure that I send it out because I would love to be able, especially with all of our listeners in Florida, so that they can contact their lawmakers and be like, no, this has got to happen. This has got to be in because it's a piece of cloth covering. It's so dumb. It's ridiculous. Luis Valdes, I so appreciate what you all do down there. I appreciate what you do for our Second Amendment rights. And thank you for always, always keeping a watch. And again, doesn't matter the letter after the name, you know, you're either for it or you're not. That's kind of how it is. Thank you, sir. Good to talk with you.
Thanks for having me on, and thanks for being a beacon of freedom in these dark and troubling times. And rock on with that Metallica shirt.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Will do. Thank you. Good to see you.